Welcome to the Great Exodus series, God's plan of rescue for all of his children. Let my people go, the path to Mount Zion. My name is Michael and I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And today our topic is, repentance is the first step on the narrow path. Repentance is something that was commanded by Jesus many times in his ministry. All the time he said, come out of the world and repent, and then take your cross and follow me. Repent, repent, repent. And also the apostles and disciples have always asked you to repent. And this is not only a lukewarm repentance one time, and then all your sins, even the future ones, will be forgiven. That is not the case, and that is not true. Salvation starts with grace and faith, no question about that. But it's a constant path, it's a constant walking forward, constant taking leap of faith all the time, and a constant repentance. Because when you are saved, your heart will know exactly, oh, this was not good what I did, I have to repent. About this one. Oh, I have said a bad word to somebody. Let me repent about this one. Then repent. And because you are saved, then your sins will be forgiven. But it needs a constant repentance. So please, people, if you come out of the world and out of Babylon, not everything is clean right away. That's the reason why it's written in the book of Revelation. The people who are standing in the multitude are this one who have made clean their dirty garments through the blood of Christ, and that requires repentance and daily repentance. As soon as you have an urge in your heart and in your mind, oh, I have done something wrong, repent about this one right away, and it will be forgiven. And because you will see and acknowledge what you have done wrong, now you will strive not to make it again. But because we are not infallible, it will happen maybe sometime again. Repent. Repentance is your way, so that the Father can see your heart and can say, this is my son and this is my daughter. They are repentant of their sins. They have understood my messages. It is very simple. If Jesus, our Lord and Savior, has asked you to repent, then why don't you repent? Why do you say this is works? Then you will stand in direct opposition to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And when you do that, then you are not walking the righteous path. And then you are not walking the narrow path. And then you will never go in the escape of the bride. Also, I believe we will see definitely surprises of people who have vanished in the escape of the bride, and where we would have said they would never go. But who are we that we should judge? We should not judge. Judgment is mine, says the Lord. So he will look into the hearts. We cannot do that. And if we find something pleasing, he will take them. But don't worry if you're not part of the escape of the bride. Of course, try to be as perfect as possible. And I pray that you all be part of the bride and accounted worthy to escape all these things that will come onto the earth. This is your main goal, but if you miss it because of something that you have not realized yet, then there is a rapture at Mount Zion. Then there is a walking the narrow path and gathering the harvest, the multitude in white. This is the next step, the next chance then for you. Don't miss out on that one, because it will be definitely tough already to reach Mount Zion through the times of the seals. But if you miss the rapture at Mount Zion, then you will end up in the times of trumpets. And I do not wish for anybody to be there. Because it needs, even from the Lord's side, mighty warriors, the 144,000, to survive that time. And you can imagine how bad it will be. Don't think that the times of the seals will be easy. You read the book of Revelation, you know what will happen. Many people will die. Many people will become martyrs. It will not be an easy time. On the contrary, it will be a testing time. But if you stand strong and you overcome, then you will be rewarded with heavenly crowns. And you will shine as the stars in heaven. And you bring many people to righteousness. I'm Michael, and I'm sending you this message out of love, so that you find your way now just at the doorstep of the escape of the bride. And if you repent completely and put all your heart there, I pray that you go with the bride. But if not, then we are here for you. When darkness falls and judgment strike, then we are here. Remember my words, we are here for you. And you can walk with us together, under the wings of the Father, to his holy mountain. Be ready, be prepared. Watch our videos, become a member of Triple Grace of the website. Many people are saying, oh, let Michael talk, he has no idea what he's talking about. But they say the same to all the prophets before. I'm not calling myself a prophet, I'm just Michael. A lone voice, nothing else. But they did it to the prophets before, and they did it to Jesus himself. They rejected all his messages because they could not discern the signs of the times. And that is exactly what's happened now too. We are not talking about the wicked ones. They will do and continue wickedly. They will never change. We are talking about Christians who have not walked the true path, who are lukewarm, who are following false doctrines of once saved, always saved, and hyper grace, and gospel of prosperity, gospel of poverty, is all fake and false. It is easy to do that, and it's complacent to do that. There's nothing involved. That's the reason why these people are saying we should not make any work, because they don't want to lift up from their seats. They don't want to help. They don't want to bring forth. They don't want to support. They don't want to share their wealth that is given by the Lord. And they don't want to support the needy. And they are not looking for the Lazarus at their gates. They are claiming to be saved forever, and that's enough. And they will have a rude awakening. Many tears will fall. Many cries will be heard. But then at least I hope they will all wake up and find that narrow path to Mount Zion. I love you all so dearly, and I wish you a great day. And I hope that you will come back to my next video tomorrow, so that we can talk about another topic. But please, repentance is the first step on the narrow path to Mount Zion. So repent daily. You feel in your heart when you are saved, when you do something wrong. Turn to the Father, turn to Jesus, and repent, and it will be forgiven. Nobody else can forgive you the sins, and no man can forgive you the sins. Don't fall in the trap of the Catholics. Nobody can forgive you your sins, only Jesus and the Father. Be part of us. Be part of Triple Grace. Be part of the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And if you're guided, support our full-time ministry, that we can reach the farthest corner of the world, that we can gather the people together in the great harvest, be the multitude clothed in white. We need your help. Come forth. Do an act of loving kindness and support us. All the links for that are in the description box below. Walk with us together. Be a harvest worker. Be a true son and daughter of the Most High, of Yahweh, of the Father. And be raptured into paradise at Mount Zion and receive your mention as a gratitude for your harvesting work, for your bringing in the pearls to heaven. My name is Michael. I am the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And have a blessed day, and I will see you again tomorrow. Maranatha.